I keep looking for a place to fit in where I can speak my mind. And I've been trying hard to find the people that I won't leave behind. They say I got brains, but they ain't doing me no good. I wish they.
Every year Pullback happens, and the main message overall that I want the audience to take away from is that this realization of the power of youth.
I absolutely loved it.
Film stuck, wrong, trapped in the audacity.
Pull Back the Curtain is a youth scriptwriting initiative that has been around since 2014. It was created by the Hong Kong Youth Arts Foundation and funded by the Miller Performing Arts. And basically, it's a fantastic opportunity for youth playwrights and youth performers to actually pull back the curtain and to have a look at how pieces of theatre are made, right from their conception, right from the scriptwriting stage. As far as the program this year and the pieces we've chosen, it's based a lot around identity and this idea of identity, which is something that's very important to teenagers, how they identify themselves.
I was born a boy.
You are my faith, Christian.
I'm not gay.
We have a piece for the dramatic reading called Self-Care, written by Miko Bojola-Bora. And it's a really interesting piece about mental health and about self-care, not only for your body, but for your mental well-being.
When was the last time you felt like this? Or how does that make you feel?
Considering like how many like teenagers are feeling the pressure of like modern society nowadays with their education and like mental illness, it helped me remind myself to take care of my own mental illness.
For our blocked reading, we have a really hard-hitting piece, something really unique by Samantha.
I always want to write something related to same-sex relationship. I have some friends, they are LGBT. Some of them has even come out to their family already. Because knowing their stories, I would like people to also understand them more.
I think definitely this piece has impacted my life because having to play a character who is transitioning from male to female has really allowed me to be more empathetic towards transgenders, and it's allowed me to see how important it is to have a supportive family and supportive network.
Aaron's represent the love and the fear and also the concern that LGBT people might have in this society. She also going through some fear of like revealing the real sex to the one she loves. We can tell that she's going through the process of rebuilding her own image and also her life stories of herself. It takes a lot of support from the others that surround by hers.
Each person in someone's life is affected by even the smallest of changes. And I think that's something that I understand more now because this piece really highlights that.
It means a lot.
And then for our fully realized production, we have a piece by Alex Gannon called What Makes a Man? And the main themes in that are surrounding male mental health and the negative effects of toxic masculinity.
What makes a man? I've been asking myself that for a very long time.
To be honest, a lot of what came from What Makes a Man is personal things that I've gone through, personal experience. There's been times where people have said to me, well, what I'm doing, maybe perhaps dancing or singing or acting, in the sense of because you're a guy. A lot of the times society makes, it results in people feeling the need to internalize a lot of their emotions. There's a stigmatism around guys opening up and talking to people about their feelings. Guys, they feel like they can't go to school counsellors, they can't speak to their parents. And I guess that's obviously why I wanted to bring the subject to light in What Makes a Man. So it's very important for young guys and teenage guys as well, because these are the most important in development of your person, your personality, and yourself as a whole.
I don't know what's wrong with you.
To to me, acting is not faking, it is quite the opposite, especially in its truest form. And in this piece, I had to understand certain characters' motivations and their actions, and this changed my daily life as I began to observe what I was saying and when I was saying it, how could it truly affect someone. The piece also focused on natural character interaction and reaction, and this changed the way I held conversations as I began to actively listen to what someone was saying instead of passively and impatiently waiting to get my point in.
Jesus Christ, Mom! Just leave me alone already! I told you nothing's up! What's so difficult to understand?
I think the main thing that I would really like the audience to take away from What Makes a Man is that if you want to do something, nobody can really tell you that you can't do it. If that's something you really are passionate about and you want to do, you should be able to do that like everybody else. You shouldn't have to feel confined to this sort of box that society's made for you. You should be able to branch out of it. You should really do whatever makes you happy and make what makes you truly happy. And I think another thing is that I want to get across is that if there are things that are bothering you, I want people to realize that it's perfectly okay to be a guy and have emotions. Everyone has them. It's a perfectly human thing, and you should be able to speak to anyone about it. Although it's hard, and it really is hard because of the pressure that society puts on males for expressing their emotion, it really shouldn't be the case. No matter who you are, you should be able to reach out and speak to people because there's always people there.
I think a lot of people that come to see the show, they're blown away by the craft and the talent and the skill, not only in the writing but in the performers. So I think it's just them realizing that power of youth as a whole, that actually these young adults can come together and create something that is really of a very, very high standard.
It was good to revisit Pull Back the Curtain because like I was in Pull Back in the past 2 years, and it was as a script writer in the classes. But this time, it was good to like revisit it, but in a different sort of light as an actor in another person's piece.
The director or the teacher really gave us a lot of opportunity to try on new things. Usually, I don't think of combining different elements in my writing.
But Pull Back. It was such a fantastic opportunity to go and learn and really go into it and try something new. The people that were doing the course as well were really nice people, and it was great to make friends. Lucky to say I've got friendships with new people now. I really urge people, if you do like writing or you've never written before, like I hadn't written before, to definitely go out and try for it because it's a really good opportunity to do.
It's heaven or hell with mom and dad just trying to stay strong. Just hide a cabin to cry for help. 19% don't want to live out loud, so we hear about them trying to tie a new spam. Just like that, my friends let loose. He says I could cut off my circulation and my bitterness, or cut off my air so I can breathe in hopefulness. Feel I'm stuck, wrong, trapped in